Hi you guys, this is Queensaundraxo and I'm coming to you guys with another video, and this video is what is your married life going to be like? So you guys said that you wanted crystals, so we're gonna do crystals, which is my citrine, my amethyst, and my pink quartz, A, B, and C. I'm still having my special for 5 questions for $20, and I think I don't have any more announcements. I love you guys. Thank you guys for watching. Very supportive. You know, you guys mean the world to me. That's it, pretty much. Okay, so we're going to get started with pile A. Pick the pile that best resonates with your energy. Always remember to go to your first mind, because your first mind is your best mind, and then we're going to get started. So, for my pile A, how is your married life going to be? So we're going to go with your past, because if I don't see what your past is, I can't see what your future is, you know? So what is going on right now with your love situation? Oh, shit. Something's about to happen fast with y'all. That card, okay, it didn't fly across the room. I thought it did. Okay, let's see what's going on. So you've been brokenhearted by a King of Wands. Join the club. This is Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, Tower, 7 of Swords, and the 3 of Swords. Okay, so to sum this up, it just means that this person, like, something happened with this King of Wands, the Sagittarius, Leo, Aries, that broke your heart, and it felt like they were being very selfish, being very deceitful, like they were out for themselves, and it destroyed your foundation. Maybe they feel like they had options, or you feel like you had options, and they didn't want to commit, so they didn't have spiritual balance, and then they came to a conclusion, fighting and just having negative energy. This doesn't seem too good. Okay. Okay, the Fool card. Oh, you're going to take a leap of faith that's going to make you happy. What's this leap of faith, though? With who? Is it with them? Oh, then you have the 2 of Cups and then the 8. Oh, yeah, you ain't leaving this person. That ain't happening. You ain't leaving, girl? Oh, God. Even though you feel like this person is definitely a burden on your life, you're not going nowhere. You're not going nowhere. This King of Swords. Okay, so give me 1 second. Let me converse with spirits real quick. Okay, let me move this up. I'm so organized with my cards today. Ooh, look at you, girl, trying to get your shit together. It's not gonna last long. But so the Fool card. So who's gonna take this leap? Is it gonna be this king, or is it gonna be this queen? A queen, or is it gonna be another king? You know, love is love. Who is gonna take this leap of faith? Oh, I'm hearing a Queen of Pentacles. Okay, a Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. She's gonna take a leap of faith on this connection. She feels bound to it. This feminine feels very bound to this connection, but it's like, no matter what happens or what they did, you guys still both feel that connection. This King of Swords, someone who, I hear Gemini, but someone who, I feel like, okay, so this is your energy, wanting to take a leap of faith that will make you happy. You still feel bound to this connection. But this person feels like they have a lot of stress in their life, and they're still being hopeful, but also being very selfish. Right, that's some shit. So, what is, I honestly want to know, because this, your situation now seems like you guys are very stagnant, they on some bullshit, very selfish, wanting you in their life, but being selfish to the point where they're not making any effort, and you're still like, oh man, I'm going to keep hope out, because, well, no, that's them keeping hope out, but you're like, I'm going to take this leap of faith, I think it's going to make me happy. So, let's see. What is going to happen for them to what's going to change into marriage. How is this going to get to marriage? Because this is married life. This is not just like, oh, I'm still fucking him after 8 years. You know what I'm saying? Which I hope y'all not still fucking people after 8 years if they ain't make no commitment. That's a long fucking time. At least can I be a fucking girlfriend? You know what I'm saying? Okay. King of Pentacles, the Hermit, the Three of Swords, and the Page. So what is going to happen to make this person commit and marry this other person? I heard, girl, look at you. Look at you showing up and being like, fuck you, nigga. I'm not dealing with your bullshit. There you go. Look, the five of Swords, all about fighting. Okay, so I feel like this person is going to feel like bound to you. I feel like you guys both feel bound to this connection. And then it's like it's going to get to a point where they're tired of heartbreak. They're going to try to disconnect from their ego and want to take a leap of faith with you. I feel like it's going to get to the point where they're going to miss you. Because you're going to come very, very clear about what you want. And you're not going to stand for bullshit no more. And then all of this is going to come to a completion. Then they're going to be like, where'd my baby go? I definitely think that. That's how that seems. This is definitely how it seems. Especially you seeing the Queen of Swords. She don't fucking play. That's Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. The Queen of Swords is very, look. She like, what's up? She got her wand. She got her sword up. And she like, okay, if you come past me, you got to be very clear about what you say. Because I'm going to cut your ass with this sword. If you lie to me. So how is this masculine, this king, going to feel about this queen? And I'm not going to spend all this time on y'all, on this thing with y'all. Yep, I told you y'all not together right now. It's like they're going to pay attention to you're not making the effort anymore. And then they're going to be like, oh, damn, where's my baby? And start thinking about you. Then start wanting to make the effort. And that's when they're going to come back around. Okay, so we got to the point where they've been on some fuck shit. They're going to realize that they miss you. They're going to want you because you're not going to be dealing with their fuck shit anymore. There you go. There's a tip. Oh, look, these four cards came out. Love, moving forward, being defensive, but keeping hope. And then it's going to get to a point where this person is going to... So it's going to get to a point where, you know, it's like, I never knew what I had until it's gone type of energy. And so this person's going to be like, my baby, like, let's move forward. Like, you know, I feel this. Let me offer you this cup because I feel this love with you. And I want to move forward into a new direction. And you're going to be still kind of defensive, but willing and being hopeful about it. Right? Good. Spirit said I'm on motherfucking track. Okay, so let's go to the married life. How is your married life going to be? Tell me a little bit about Spirit. How is their married life going to be for Pi A? Spirit says it's going to be good. It's going to be very exciting. It's going to be everything that you've been wanting for so long. I hear 5 years. 5 years until they get married? It's five. So is it the number of change or is it just the timing? I feel like it's the number of change. So if it's 555, let me see it then. Because 555 is all about change. It's all about things moving forward. Your angels are watching you and you're about to get some dick. This is my personal deck too. I think I'm going to make a real deck. I don't know. I need help with that one. Yeah. So I feel like you're going to get to the point where you are... Is that right? Okay. I feel like this person's going to marry you because you're going to get pregnant. So, but I was about to say something else. You're going to get very dedicated on yourself. Very dedicated to your craft. Very dedicated to your education. Very dedicated to your job. Very dedicated to you and building your own wealth and success. And they're going to see that. Definitely see that. And then they're going to be like, well, maybe if I call her and give her some dick, she'll be nice to me. And then you're going to end up pregnant, and that's when commitment's going to happen. Oh, look, a romance. You're in alignment, though. You're in alignment with your energy, and it's just a Drake song, Drake 9. It says, I made a decision last night that I would die for it, just to show the city what it takes to be alive for it. So it's saying, like, you know, I made a decision to work on me. Fuck everybody else. I'm about to show everybody who I can be and what I can become. You know what I'm saying? But I feel like what's going to happen is they're going to realize that you're not paying attention to them anymore. And it's going to get them to a point where they're not satisfied because they don't have you like they used to. Health. Hey, you got it. Trust the process. This quote is off of Quavo's song. I think it's Bubblegum something. But in this quote is saying, he's like, hey, you got it. Trust the process. So it's like, you got this, but you have to trust in spirit and allow spirit to work on it. You know, you got this. And spirit is saying, like, right now is the time for you to concentrate on you because this person's coming back because they're going to miss you. And look, fuck them. Leave them alone and fuck them. This can mean two things. Should they actually literally fuck them or should they just be like, fuck that nigga? Which one should they do? Both. Spirit says, get that dick, then go home. Like, don't cuddle up. Don't try to, you know, make them feel good and shit. Spirit said, get that dick and go home. Okay, well, or get that pussy and go home, you know. Within a month. Any other card, Spirit? Are we supposed to be talking about your fucking married life, not how to get this motherfucker? Okay, let me move on. My mind is everywhere. And this card wanted to come out again. So it's saying that this person is the one, this King of Wands, this King of Wands, King of Swords energy. He or she is the one. It's masculine. It's the one for you. Or it could potentially be one because we all have more than one person that we can be with. We don't have to settle for what we don't think we deserve. Okay, so for Pal A, how is their married life going to be? You guys are going to feel just like bound to each other. Just bound to each other. He's going to be a good father. He or she is going to be a good father. And the way you guys communicate is communicate like heart-wise. The way you guys love is going to be the same love language. And I suggest anybody that's in a relationship to buy, it's called 5 Signs or 5 Love Languages or something like that. And read it and get very in tune with it because you can figure out everybody doesn't love the same. But you guys do. So that's a good thing. Knight of Swords, Renewal, Queen of Earth. Didn't I tell you the Queen of Pentacles? Spirit told me to tell you that. And then the Wheel. So, for your married life, I feel travel is a thing. Travel is definitely a thing. I feel like you're going to have good luck and building a family. And things are going to happen with great speed. Once they get to the point where they are realizing that you are of quality to them. Even though I'm pretty sure they realize it. But once they realize that you really are something special, they're going to run after you, and it's going to happen real fast. Like, your relationship's going to take off. Yeah, because they've been in the energy of the Knight of Pentacles, like, being, like, slow and shit to commit, slowing shit to, like, be there. They taking a fucking time. Don't you hate that shit? The King of the Knight? I hate seeing the Knight of Pentacles when I do my readings on myself. Plans that need revision, more going on that meets the eye. Like, they are in an energy of poor timing right now. But once that timing kicks in and they get in their head that they need you, shit's going to happen so fast. It's going to happen so fast. And then it's going to bring, I was about to say it's going to bring a fourth life. I also think that it's going to bring fourth life. But it's like, I'm not describing your married life. I'm describing the situation. But anyways, this is what I'm getting from Spirit. It's going to be an inflow. Like, it's going to happen real fast. And, like, money's going to be doing good. Love is going to be doing good. It's going to be a potential for recreating some staple. And it's stable. And it's going to be something that's going to be, like, you're going to have them concretely there on this earthly plane. As well as their emotions, if that makes any type of sense. Because the Ace of Pentacles is all about earth. It's all about stability. It's all about this world. It's all about being in this reality. So you're going to have this new beginning in this reality and this new beginning in love. And it's going to feel like a soulmate connection. Like, you guys getting back on the same energy. And you guys are going to end up making a lot of money and building a happy home life. But I want to get into, like, the actual marriage. And then we can move on. So how is the actual married life going to be? Oh, my personal readings. That's what I missed. Oh, I'll say it at the end of the video. You're gonna be anxious sometimes though, because I feel like you're gonna be scared that they're gonna fall back into their old fucking energy, you know what I'm saying? But it's gonna be a wish fulfillment. I told you that too. It's gonna be a wish fulfillment. And you guys are gonna definitely be partners. Definitely be partners in love. You guys are gonna fight not as much as you used to, but it's some energy there. But you guys are gonna gain strength and things are gonna move forward. You're gonna have fortune on your side. Family's gonna be built. Spirit's gonna show you directions that you guys need to be going in. A favorable assessment. Yeah, you guys are gonna love each other. Truly love each other. Be truly in love. That's all I can say. And truly in love. And it's gonna happen fast. It's gonna happen fast. Anything else you wanna tell about A Spirit? Spirit is saying that when it comes to this connection, I know you might have a lot of fear, but you need to release that fear. Release that fear so you can have goodness. Open fully. Like, I feel like it's gonna be a lot of communication as well. A lot of secrets being revealed. A lot of getting to know each other, trusting the process. Didn't I tell you trusting the process? And divine timing. Like, this person might be slow as fuck now, but once spirit kicks in and divine timing's at play, this relationship's gonna happen so fast. I feel like in 3 years, is it 3 years from now? Okay, so that 555 was about change, about things happening quickly, because that's what a 555 is about. So that makes a lot of sense. But what's this 3 years saying? Spirit says in 3 years, you're going to have a baby and a husband, a family. It's going to come out of nowhere, coming from not having a family to having a family. This person is still very indecisive, but like coming very soon, you guys are going to disconnect with each other. It's not going to be to the point where... Okay, they told me to change it. No. Okay, I'm getting two messages. It's saying that, like, very soon, like, this relationship is going to happen quickly. Like I said before, it's going to happen soon. You guys are going to disconnect. It's not going to be, like, full extent of let's make it work, let's make it last, you know what I'm saying? Keep sweat. But it is going to be something of value to each other. Something of value. So, anything last messages about their love, their marriage? Yeah, y'all get back together. Y'all get back together. Because your affirmations and your prayers and all those feelings, those positive thinking, positive thoughts is bringing you to your husband or bringing you to your wife. Because your feelings are real. It's a real thing. So for your married life, I feel like it's going to just happen very quickly. Like, it's going to come out of nowhere. You're going to have a marriage. You're going to have babies. You're going to have a family. And if you already have children, whatever, it's going to happen to the point where, like, you guys are going to get family very quickly. Like, it's gonna happen very quickly. Very, very quickly. I hope I explained that marriage real good. I don't know. But it's going to be a lot of flirting energy. And you guys are going to feel like it's going to be love. It's going to be true love. True love. Someone that you've known from the past. Someone that you have good sex with. And just let it happen. Oh, shit, let's do the sex real quick. Damn, I'm on 18 minutes? Fuck. Oh, God. Okay. We'll do this married the sex life later. Because I can't be on here doing 18 minutes for one pal. We're going to move. Oh, and if you guys want a personal reading, it's thelovemealways.com. Thank you for watching the video. Like, subscribe, and comment down below if it resonated. But we're going to move to pal B. So for pal B, how is your relationship going right now? Because I can't know the future if I don't know the present. Or the past. What's happening? What's happening? Another king of fucking wands. This king of wands is destroying everybody's fucking life. So this Leo Sagittarius Aries is going within to gain inner strength so that he or she can accomplish life. I feel like they're trying to conquer the demons. So that's why they retreat. You might think they're on some fuck shit. And they might be on some fuck shit. I'm not even gonna lie to you. But I feel like truly this person is trying to gain strength, gain knowledge, get themselves together. Is this reverse? I'm sorry. Is this reverse or upright? Okay. So, but see, the thing is, even though this King of Wands has his back or her back towards this Empress, they feel this emotion towards you. They feel this emotion towards this Empress. Okay, King of Pentacles coming up too. This is a good father. This is a good man. Somebody who's going to provide. Very fruitful and abundant. This King of Pentacles. He's Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus. And then it's this this Queen of Swords who's a Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. She's like, no, 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 no. Don't try me. What you got to say and be clear with it. Because I'm not dealing with no bullshit today. So you guys fight. And you guys both feel left out in the cold. But you guys are definitely, even though you guys are not the same suit, I feel like you guys are definitely a couple. And if they are denying that, they on some fuck shit because they know it. And they recognize that. And that's the first energy I feel. But someone's not content in what they want right now. Feeling trapped in a connection. Feeling trapped into something. Well, who is this and what do they feel trapped about? You feel trapped. You're not happy with what's being offered to you. I think y'all are together spiritually, but not physically on this plane, if that makes any type of sense. So what's going to get them to the point where they're making a commitment? The Justice card. Karma. Karma's a son of a bitch. That's why I don't do half the shit I be wanting to do. That's why I don't do half the shit. It's gonna be the type of energy where you guys are gonna wanna have. Hold on, let me finish pulling. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. This King of Pentacles, he or she is gonna feel left out in the cold. This divine masculine is gonna feel left out in the cold. And then they're going to want to come in and they're going to want to work on it. They're going to want to feel like, you know, bring justice to the situation, justice to the relationship, bringing balance, bringing like good karma, good energy, because they're going to feel like you left them and you're not dealing with their bullshit no more. So they're like, damn, where's my baby? So this Page of Wands, it's like they're going to feel like they need to get balance. So they're going to go off on this journey and try to work on this relationship. Try to work on themselves so they can be best for you. So what you going to do? What's going to happen? What you going to say? Yeah, y'all feel that soulmate. That spiritual energy. Spiritual balance. Spiritual balance is going to come in and that's what this person is going to realize. That I think that's going to be the thing. Is this upside down or upright? So it's like a choice is going to be made because they feel like they don't have the best choices in front of them. So I feel, you know how sometimes people be like, I don't like what's in front of me, so I'm going to go to what I know works. So they're going to be searching for something that they can't ever find because they already found it in you. And that's going to wake them up and they're going to be like, damn, I need to stop being so defensive and open my fucking mouth. Okay. So let's see how your married life's going to be, because you're going to say yes, right? You wouldn't be here if you wanted to say no. So how is your married life going to be for Pile B? Look at you coming up to Queen of Wands. This is Leo, Sagittarius, Aries. Very fiery, very passionate, very sexy. Got her titties out. Well, her titties not really out, but you know, she got a little slit in her chest. Very fiery. Look at the baby, giddy. That look like my Baco. But yeah. You know me be underneath my feet. Oh, there you go. Y'all want to see him? Because y'all saw my white one. Pal B always see my cats for some reason. Oh, come here, Poppy. Come here, say hello, Mama. Oh, goodness. Let's see if you can see it. Okay, Pop, you gotta look at the camera. That's him. Say hi, Nunu. Okay. Thank you for your energy, Poopy. Okay, Judgment card. I have more than one nickname for my cats. His name is Choco Baco. His real name is Choco. But I call him Choco Baco, I call him Nunu, I call him Poppy, I call him a lot of shit. They just respond when they hear my voice. Okay, the Judgment card. So it's like, I feel like even you're going to be tired of their shit and you're going to get a wake-up call as well. And then you're going to see them like, ooh, look at you. I feel like the roles are going to be reversed. So they're going to be feel left out in the cold, and you're going to be like, I mean, I hear you, spirit, but I'm about to take my time to this connection because they took their time. I'm about to take my time. Shit. But you're going to be like, damn, I do miss my baby. I do want this happy celebration. I do miss them. But you're still going to be thinking about that heartbreak, that old past. But look, things are going to be changing in your energy as well. Trying to move forward in a better direction because you're going to be like, yeah, I miss this King of Cups, this Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio. So it's like you're going to be taking a walk towards them, not a run, out of fear of having to wait for them again and heartbreak and things not changing. So you're going to stay still and let them come to you. But this King of Cups is going to always be on your mind. Okay, that's your energy. Good for you, girl. Fuck that nigga. Good for you. So let's see how your married life is going to be. How's Pal B's married life going to be? It's going to take a little minute. Like, you have done everything that you can to get this marriage off the ground. And the spirit is saying that leave that shit at the door. Once you do everything you can, let that plant blossom. You know what? Honestly, I'll get something else. Oh, yeah. This came out. This was on top twice, so we're going to keep that out. This relationship is going to definitely be a wish fulfillment for you with this King of Cups. I think, is it going to be for him or is it going to be for her? Or the masculine energy? You are their wish fulfillment. But I don't feel like you're going to budge. I feel like it's going to take you some time to get your energy together. Definitely. It's like you are trying to nurture on something else. And this person's like, I need my baby. Because they're holding a cup and then you got the Nine of Cups. So it's like, if I bring my cup to this person, we can have it all. We can have it all. So how's your married life going to be? You ain't going no fucking way. Don't even lie. It's Eight of Swords. That's the card of being trapped and loving being trapped. Balance. So how is this marriage going to be, though? How is the marriage life going to be? I feel like your marriage life is going to be round and round and round and round. Good, bad, good, bad, good, bad. Very anxiety-driven, being defensive, but still having that soulmate connection, wanting to be structured in this connection. I feel like it's going to be a lot, to say the least. I feel like life is going to get in the way, too. Sometimes life is going to be a burden for you guys. But I honestly, how is this marriage going to be? Yeah, it's going to take some time to get where it needs to be. I feel like timing is an issue, definitely. But I feel like this relationship is going to have its goods and have its bads. Are they going to get divorced? That's to be determined. But spirit is telling you to keep an open mind, and you guys are both going to be addicted to each other. It's going to be kind of toxic a little bit. But... Y'all not gonna break up, cause y'all gonna wanna give it a true love. But it's gonna be something. It's gonna be, you know how you just can't put your finger on it. It's going to be something. Something's gonna happen. But this person is definitely, you guys are gonna be loving each other. But see, with this relationship, you loving yourself is going to be the only way this relationship works, because if you don't rely on yourself and put all your energy into this connection, it's not going to work. I can tell you that right now. It's not going to fucking work. But if you put the work into yourself and then allow this person to come along, then that's when the relationship's going to work. But it's saying that you deserve love, but loving yourself first makes you more romantically attractive. You being true to yourself. But it's going to be a lot of flirting, a lot of energy over, I want to fuck you. I love you, like you my baby. Yeah, but y'all gonna probably need counseling. I'm gonna be honest with you. Y'all not gonna wanna not make it work, but y'all gonna need some help. Because it don't seem like it's gonna be smooth sailing. But very soon you actually calling this energy into your life. So it's gonna happen. This person's coming around. This person's definitely coming around you soon. Sorry for the fucked up reading. It's just, I'm gonna be honest with y'all. I'm never gonna sugarcoat shit. Because that's not life. Life, I wish, oh, that'd be so nice if life sugarcoated shit with me. But they don't, so. Yeah. If you like the reading, subscribe to the channel, comment down below. And if you want to purchase the reading, it's thelovemealways.com. But we're going to move on to Pal C. So for Pal C, how is your marriage going to be? What's going on now? Because I can't figure out the future if I don't know the past. So what is going on with the past? Indecisiveness of love. Indecision if you want to actually get married. If you want a relationship. Okay. What else is going on for Pal C? I understand that too. Shit. Seven of Cups. The Eight of Fire. Page of Water. The Eight of Pentacles. Knight of Pentacles, Ten of Pentacles, money. Okay. Oh. Okay, let me get out all out. Okay, so a new person has stirred your romantic feelings. You got a new person coming. This is gonna be somebody that you don't know. But when they come along, they're gonna be on some fuck shit. So just beware. And I feel like when they come along, you're gonna actually have options. But I don't think, oh, they're going to be doing some fuck shit and they're going to take their time with you. But I feel like this person's going to be very loyal and dedicated to the relationship. It's not going to happen as fast as you would like it to, but it's definitely going to happen. I feel like there's some energy over wanting to be in rest mode and wanting to evaluate your life. But this connection is going to come in and be like, what's that song called? I'm going to play it for y'all. Hopefully I don't get demonetized for that either, but fuck it, you know what I'm saying? Oh damn, what is it called? Who is it by? Shit. Deborah Cox. It's by Deborah Cox. It's by Deborah Cox and it's called No Spot. Nobody's supposed to be here. On a search to find. Okay, this is you. Again, love has not been down. My heart got broken, you know it hurts so bad. I'm sad to say love wins again. So I place my heart under lock and key. Ooh, yeah. To take some time and take care of me. But I turn around and you're standing here. Coming up, and I hope y'all heard that. I hope it wasn't too staticky. And sorry for the headphone people. Just turn it down. But pretty much she's saying is, you know, my heart has been closed. Ain't nobody supposed to be even. I'm not even looking for this shit. And then I turn around and there you go. So that's, I think that's what's going to happen with you guys. You're not going to be in a place of wanting a relationship. Not going to be in a place of wanting to deal with people's bullshit. And then they're going to come along and be like, what's up? And you're going to be like, damn, I'm back in love. I'm back in love. Okay, so what's going on for Pal C? Go have sex. Just do it. So this might be a booty call. And then you're going to be like, man, fuck them afterwards. Oh, you're going to feel a past life connection to them. Okay. Yep, you need some pussy or some dick. You'll... you need some dick or some pussy, you'll be fine, relax. And then it's this one is like, just do it, it will make you feel better. So, my personal cards, don't mind them. Actually, I really think like this person's gonna be a booty call. Like somebody that you just feel very sexually attracted to. And then it's gonna happen and be like, oh man, I kinda really like this person. You know, what the fuck is going on? I'm not supposed to be concentrating on love. Supposed to be doing, girl, so much sex, oh, this is so much energy over you fucking. This person's gonna be a fuck buddy. Definitely. Definitely, definitely, definitely. And then love is gonna happen. And then you're gonna start feeling left out in the cold, because this is one of my favorite songs. It says, I need some real good loving, because I've been troubled by the things that I see. I need some real good loving. Ain't nobody been around here loving on me. So you're gonna be like, damn, this person is honestly coming around trying to love on me, and maybe I should give them a chance. Because it also says, I feel like this person is going to actually hide some feelings towards you at first, or somebody's going to be hiding feelings. Because it says, so many things I've got to tell you, but I'm afraid I don't know how, because there's a possibility that you'll look at me differently. Love. This song, this lyric, I suggest you guys go listen to that song. It's by Ludacris, Good Loving, and it's pretty much saying, like, you know, I'm like, just get sum it up. It says, I'm scared of what's going on. I need somebody to come in here and love on me, because I'm scared of what I'm seeing. I'm scared of how I'm feeling. You know what I'm saying? So how is your married life going to be with this fuck buddy? Because it's a whole bunch of energy over you getting some dick, girl. Oh, God. Y'all are going to create life. Oh, I didn't mean to say that, but I guess you guys are going to have babies together. But you guys aren't going to create a lot of things out of being discontented with what you have in front of you. It's like you guys are going to come to, look at the Ten of Pentacles working, the Eight of Pentacles working, the King of Pentacles, Capricorn, Virgo, Taurus working, Two of Cups, this Knight of, he's very dedicated to something. Is he successful? Very. He might have his own business. Should I hope this is my pal? Fuck. But you're going to have a very happy home life, for financial security. Money's not going to be an issue. And I feel like this person might work a lot. But you're going to have fun with them. Definitely have fun. And you're not going to all... I feel like sometimes you might feel discontent because they might work a lot. But I was about to say, but bitch, get you your own fucking money. Go get you your own job, okay? Do your own shit. So you don't have to always think about this person not being around. A contentment and rewarding family, you're going to have a very happy life with them. Money's going to be good. Emotions are going to be good. They're going to tell you how they feel. They're very romantic. You're going to have fun with them. It's not going to be stress. It's going to be very relaxing. I feel like there's going to be, like, disagreements. You know what I'm saying? Like, you guys are not going to always see eye to eye. But it's definitely going to be a situation where you guys are listening to one another. It's going to be love. This seems like very... very stable energy. Plans and revision. More going on that meets the eye. But here's the fuck shit. Here is the fuck shit. So, is this marriage or is this before? Is this before the marriage or during? So, the reason why this person is going to commit to you is because you're not going to, I feel like somebody's going to walk away from somebody. And it's not going to be the most positive energy. But they're going to want something stable with you. I feel like it's going to be to the point where someone's going to feel trapped, and then they're going to get a revelation that they can't keep doing this shit no more. And then someone's going to leave, and then they're going to come back because... someone's going to leave, and then something's going to happen when you guys come back around each other. And then it's going to start over. And y'all might end up having sex again, and then it's going to reignite that passion. So for your marriage, I feel like you have a good marriage. You're going to have some bullshit, but we all have bullshit. It's life, okay? Life was peachy keen. We will always be happy 24/7, but that shit is not realistic. But you'll be fine. He or she seems very stable. They want to work at it. They're going to bring you money. You might feel neglected at times because they might be a definite workaholic. But it says this person has the Midas touch, and you're going to have a very happy family life and financial security. Life is going to be magical. Look, finding magic in the little things in life, and then life is magical. Yeah, you guys are actually going to create a lot of things together. Like, y'all might even go to business together. It's nice. And I don't feel like you guys are going to get divorced at all. You might feel some type of way, but you also have your own energy, ma'am. Spirit is saying, look, this Five of Swords is all about being selfish. So, getting your own energy, stretch your wings and fly and concentrate on your own happiness. So, it will make your own happiness. Plant your own seed so that when it's time for harvest, you will have your own shit. You won't have to rely on anybody. But you're going to have a happy outcome, and it's time for you to go on your own journey. Be confident in yourself. Confident. That's a big thing. Look. And then it says, okay, so confident. And then it says, have confidence in yourself. Okay, so I feel like the discontentment might be coming because you're not confident in yourself, not knowing what you can and will achieve. That's what's going to make this relationship kind of be teeter-tottering. But once you get into your own energy and concentrate on yourself, things is going to be a breeze. Okay? So if you like this reading, like the reading, subscribe to the channel, comment down below if it resonated. And if you want a personal reading, it's thelovemealways.com. And I'll talk to you guys in the next one.